Jason Zucker, not only great on the ice, but very generous off the ice. Joining us right now via FaceTime from Minnesota, where it's a big night. Of course, Zucker won the King Clancy Memorial Trophy this year for his charitable efforts. And Jason, I understand that now you're taking those charitable efforts and highlighting other people who are also doing really great things in the community, right?
Yeah, absolutely. First off, thanks for having me on. I appreciate it. And secondly, it's going to be a fun night. It's the first annual Give 16 Honors, and tonight we're honoring 16 individuals, nonprofits, and so on within our community here in Minnesota that are doing great things. And that came about after we won the King Clancy. We realized how much of a team effort it was throughout the entire state of Minnesota, and how much all the individuals and all these nonprofits were helping us. So we wanted to give back and award them for everything they're doing.
So, Jason, the way you can put the puck in the net for the Wild, what you do in the community, how the heck could they have even thought of trading you in the offseason? I know it was, all kidding aside, I know it was the old regime and it was kind of the trade that never happened. How do players deal with those situations, or is it just part of the business?
It's part of the business. It's the way it goes, of course. It's something that I didn't want to have happen, so it was obviously a bit of a tough time. For me, I wanted to be here. My family's from here. My kids were born here. I mean, I've been here my whole career, so it's near and dear to my heart. So it's definitely tough when it was going on, but it's something that you just have to take with a grain of salt and just know that it's part of the game. And, most people don't stay in one city their entire career.
Jason, I'm a big Bruce Boudreau guy. We've seen pictures of you guys. I cried on his shoulder when I was traded. We were very close. But I've seen pictures of the boys practicing his skating test. Have you had to practice, or is skating just so easy for you that you're just going to go float through it?
I actually don't practice it very often. I'm sure you're surprised. And it's one of those things that the best skaters typically – everyone's in good shape. That's the way our game is nowadays. I mean, everybody comes to camp in great shape. So, it's not something I necessarily practice, but I do make sure that, I'm well rested before that day. As you know, from doing it in years past, it is tough. It's definitely a bag skate for sure. And doing it after a practice doesn't make it any easier.
You can't fake it. Good luck.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it.
If you don't practice that, what do you practice? Because I know, you come ready to go when camp starts. So what does your training regimen include, and how do you stay in shape for the season?
This year I actually switched it up from what I do in years past. And I skated a lot more this summer than I typically have. Usually I would take, until this year was a little bit different, missing playoffs for sure. But usually I'd take a couple months off the ice and just train and be in the gym and those things. But this year I started on the ice a lot earlier and kept the gym a little bit easier to start, and then ramped that up later in the summer. So it was mainly skill work, working on my hands and, the little nuances of the game.
Jason, you have a new general manager in Minnesota, Billy Guerin, who I'm very familiar with, one of my all-time favorite teammates. I was fortunate enough to win a Stanley Cup with him, which was early in his career. Have you had a chance to talk with Bill and what your role may be moving forward and what you expect this season and just how Bill's been acclimated to the Wild thus far in the short time?
Yeah, absolutely. I had a chance to meet with him just the other day. He seems like a great guy. I mean, I had never met him previously. His energy and, the way he talks about the way he wants to bring this team is very exciting. For anybody that knows him and has played with him, obviously knows the confidence and energy he brings just from a daily basis. So it's exciting. It was good to sit down and talk to him, just get to know him a little bit. It was a very, brief conversation. So we didn't really get into the nitty gritty of what's going to happen this season or anything of that sort, but it was more just to get to know each other and, get acclimated that way.
Well, we can't wait for the puck to drop in just a few weeks on preseason hockey, at least. I know you have a really big night ahead of you, but before we let you go, I just wanted to get back to the whole community involvement thing, because it really says a lot about you and your wife that you were able to win the King Clancy. That's how much good work you do in the community. Why is it so important to you to stay so involved in the Minnesota community?
It's a huge passion of mine and Carly's, and for us, it's something that we feel when you have this platform, you have to use it. You have to use it to do good, and to be able to help these kids in the hospital and just make their lives better, even if it's for 5 minutes, for an hour, a couple of hours, it makes such a big difference in their lives. So for us, That's the main priority.
Jason Zucker, the founder of the Give 16 campaign. It's a great organization. Go check it out online and enjoy the big event, Give 16 Honors, tonight. Can't wait to see it on social media.
Yeah, thank you. We appreciate it. Thanks for having me on.